Hi everyone, meteorologist Chris Jarzynka with your weather on the web update. Now, southern New Hampshire saw a little bit more snow than we expected. We kind of thought that heavy snow band was going to be in central and eastern New Hampshire. Turned out to be about 20, 25 miles farther south. Boy, did it cause a mess on the roads. No two ways about it. We got 8 inches in Newton from our spotters, about 6.5 in Fremont, Nottingham getting about 6 inches, as well as Epping and Raymond, and even Hampton Beach getting between 5 and 5.5 inches of snow. Some other reports from the Hampstead area, 7.5 inches, East Derry around 7, Londonderry 0.5 foot, as well as Sandown, Salem about 5, and keep in mind it wasn't that light fluffy snow, it was that cement-like snow that stuck on everything. Merrimack in through the Merrimack Valley getting around 7 inches, Hudson also around 7, Nashua in that neighborhood too, Manchester getting anywhere between 5 and 6 inches depending on which neighborhood and which side of Manchester you were on. Off to the north and east and through Rochester, got about 7 inches, but the Gonick neighborhood in Rochester a little bit to the south got 6, Stratford got 5, Durham around the bay getting around 4.5 inches, and New Durham up towards the Lakes region, where actually I thought we would see some of the higher totals, only got 3.5 inches. By the way, the Monadnock region barely getting an inch, but you're getting some more during the evening hours and through the overnight because the storm system, although most of it is pulling away, the really heavy, steady stuff, it's got a bit of a tail on it, and this tail has to still lumber on through New Hampshire during the overnight hours. So I think it'll be more snow shower type activity where it'll be off and on versus a steady snow. But as temperatures drop below freezing, this will accumulate a bit more quickly. So we could still be talking about another half an inch of snow. Hey, I wouldn't even be shocked in some of the higher terrain if it could be an inch or 2 inches of snow. The other big problem overnight tonight is temperatures drop below freezing. Now, what happened on the roads today, besides it just being an all-out mess, was that the tires, with their friction, heated up the road and the road surface and the snow on top of it and the slush and created kind of that slushy mess. Overnight tonight, that slush refreezes and hardens, and that can cause slick spots, and you can't see as well at night because it's dark. So that could be a problem too. Just take it very carefully, and if you don't have to be outside tonight, I'd probably recommend just waiting until tomorrow morning to go out. Other than that, no big storms in sight, although we do have a cloud mass that's showing up here across the Great Lakes. This cloud mass is the leading edge of the next batch of Arctic air. More Arctic air after our January thaw week, and this stuff is even colder than the stuff we saw a couple of weeks ago. This means business and is coming in for Monday night and into Tuesday. So overnight tonight, snow showers continue. Any slush on the roads will freeze up. Low temperatures dropping as cold as 12 in the North Country, but most of us will be in the upper teens or lower to mid-20s. That is still below freezing, and that means on untreated roads, that can all ice back up, and there again will still be some passing snow showers with the storm's tail moving on through the area. So again, there could be some additional accumulation. The biggest problem would be side and untreated roads. For tomorrow on Sunday, passing snow showers in the morning, then mostly sunny and breezy, but our temperatures actually get above freezing, so whatever has frozen will then melt again. By the way, if you want to clean up whatever fell during the day on Saturday, do it on Sunday, because after that, it is not going to move for quite a while, I do not believe. There are your temperatures for Sunday, temps in the 30s. So, to recap for Sunday, we're above freezing, except up north where we'll be right around freezing, but with some sun even breaking out after some passing snow showers, in the sun, it's above freezing. It's going to be a bit breezy, so it'll feel cooler than 30s to near 40, more like the lower 30s. For our day on Monday, we get a little bit of sunshine, but a big league cold front moves on through the area. It starts in the North Country in the morning, so you really don't warm up at all. In fact, you're in the teens in the North Country with passing snow squalls. The rest of us in central and southern New Hampshire see the front moving through about 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. That means we do get above freezing, and then the temperatures plunge. They really plunge. Not terribly windy on Monday night and a Tuesday, as you might normally expect with an Arctic front coming through, but those temperatures on Tuesday are going to be very cold. We're bitterly cold again. We're below zero Tuesday night and a Wednesday morning. We don't even reach 10 in southern New Hampshire on Wednesday itself. There will be some clouds near the seacoast as an ocean storm tries to get close, but I think the Arctic air is going to be too strong and will keep it to the south of us and push it away. But even if the storm misses us, as I think it will, it's going to kick in an even greater breeze on Thursday in its wake. It's going to drag in even colder air. Lows below zero and highs barely above on Thursday with a wind chill several degrees below zero. it gets nasty again. Watch out for those heating bills. Be careful on the roads during the overnight hours, and thanks very much for clicking on this WMUR Weather on the Web videocast.